TV crew, salute. What's good? Yo, today I'll be in some different settings, you feel me? I'm taking this into the whip because y'all know my yard's being constructed, you feel me? So, as y'all can tell by the title, today I'm finna be giving y'all a little story times. Probably my first official, I can say, story time I'm giving y'all. Probably done once before, probably deleted that shit before. I don't know, can't remember, bruh. But yo, as y'all can tell by the title, the first time I got high. I'ma start it as I was 15. Y'all know I done most of my studies in the UK. When I finished my studies, I left. I moved over to an island in Africa, as some of y'all know. It started by, I had a good friend in secondary school. Secondary school is equivalent as to saying in the US, high school, some-ish like that. I had this good friend and he lived in the hood. You know what I'm saying? I lived in the hood too, but it was one of those ones. When we was growing up, like, our hoods were good, you feel me? I could walk to his hood, he could walk to mine, everything was blessed, you feel me? Obviously, there's certain roads that we couldn't take, car. Certain areas you was from, not to say you was gangbanging or shit, it's just certain people just remember your face and you couldn't walk down that road, basically. I'm saying, like, I could walk down this road behind me and I'll be pissed, you feel me? Not to say that it's this road, just giving y'all an example, you know what I'm saying? In the UK, it works like this. We was doing our GCSEs. Before you take your GCSEs, you get like a, coming into like summer break, you get like a, I think it's a 3 months holiday, but they call it revision time or whatever you call it. I can't even remember what they called it. With my revision time, bruh, I didn't like school, bruh. Cause I was a person, like y'all know in some of my videos, I was a type, I'm a type person where I like to be taught what I want to learn, you feel me? Not what the government wants me to learn, you know what I'm saying? It was the last day, my boy, I'm just gonna call him J-Boy. J-Boy was like, hey, Jay, what you saying? You want to hang out for the song? I was like, all right, bro. He's like, oh, where do you live again? I said, yo, bro, I just moved from north to east. So he's like, oh, you close to me? You're just down the road. He lived in some hood, like some blocks, estates, you feel me? Big ass shit. And I lived on like a main road, kind of leading into some blocks, you feel me? Into some big hood estate. Like, cool, bro. These times, as I was moving from north to east, my pops, he moved to the island because he didn't like the cold. So he moved over for a new life, you feel me? For a more laid back type life. So he done that, and as soon as he left, I was rubbing my hands, bro. I was thinking, you know what, cut? More freedom, baby, you know what I'm saying, bro? I only had my mom with me, so I thought, bro, I could get away with shit. Shit be more relaxed, you feel me? Because, you know, parents, how they are, especially, you know what I'm saying, from backgrounds that are cultural, they be hella strict, cut. The thing that was happy when the pops moved to the island is that, bro, there was times I would run out to the hood, chill with my homies from, like, 5 till like 1 a.m. in the morning and shit, and just run all the way home. Mama didn't have an idea where the hell I was. There was certain days that she would kind of freak out and know certain shit, but that was freedom to me, man. I went wild. But this car's hella heated up in this bit, bro. Outside kind of hot, but bro, if my face is red, you already know why, man. It's the heat cooking me up in this bit, but y'all already know I love myself some heat. Yeah, bro, check me out. Check me out. So these times now, 3 months into revision I was supposed to do at home or whatnot, bro, I didn't care about that shit, bro. Guys, don't do that shit, man. Take your studies serious. I just didn't want to do it. I chose not to because it's not what I was wanting to study, you feel me? It's just government type shit. But anyway, long story short, by the way, this is a 2 stories in one. This is like a preview of what happened and an official what happened. Y'all gonna see what I'm trying to say. Come to the first day, it was a Monday, got a text like, bro, you coming to hers? Like, bro, I've never been to your hood. And I know there's youngers, there's olders. These times I was 15, like I did say, we was young, you feel me? High school leaving into like college type shit. At the time, J-Boy was like, we were best buddies, you feel me? He would have my back, I had his back like 10 toes down, you feel me? 100, no cap. Went into his hood and I was like, bro, make sure you walk with me, cause I don't want to be slipping on no one's turf, you feel me? And getting, you know, shit happened. I won't be one of those statistics in the hood. No, sir. Bro, so we hit it up. He's like, cool, let's chill here and shit. Got to meet the homies. This carried on for like a month. Chilled. You know what I'm saying? People started to know my face. Come to a time now, the olders, bro, they were like 23, 24, but there were some hench mofos. I could see them in the corner just pre me, and I'm like, J-Boy, bro, I don't know what going on, but these guys, they're moving kind of funny for me, bro. I don't know. I feel like I just need to one hop it out the hood, cuz seeming a bit up. One of the oldest come over. He was like the main guy of the hood. He was, you know what I'm saying, general type shit. Man had the captain's armband and shit, you know what I'm saying? Run the squad. So he come to me now and he's like, bro, I like your style. And these times I was big for my age, bro. Anyone around me, bro, this guy's big for his age, you know what I'm saying? Now I'm just slim fit, you know what I'm saying? For the ladies, I didn't like being big, so I slimmed down now. He was like, yeah, I'm liking your style. You seem like a good guy and shit. What are you saying? You want to chill in the hood more often? I was like, bro, I'm just here. I ain't no gangbanging shit. Like, come chill with us. I was like, okay, shit, cool. What's up? You know what I'm saying? Bro, after a month after that, so we had one more month to chill. You feel me? The oldest come up to me and is like, bro, you're a dope guy. You seem like you got good influence on the youngest right here. We want you to stick around with the homies and shit. I was like, oh shit, cool, man. I mean, I don't mind. I ain't into no gangbanging shit. I'm just here to chill. Sometimes being wrong place at the wrong time, you never know. But bro, I was hella young. I was unexperienced into this shit. So one day he must have come up to me and I was with J-Boy again. And he was like the captain's armband, let's go. He came over, the main man, with some hench dude, bruh. Walking over to me, I was like, bro, Jay, come into the blocks, cuz. And I looked at Jay, but I was like, bro, what's up? Like, shit, are they trying to kill me and shit? I was like, bro, this getting heated. He's like, nah, bruh, they be cool. Even the older was like to me, hey, man, we straight, man. It's nothing like that. We just gonna take a little smoke. At least I was thinking, my guy trying to... cigarettes and shit. I was like, oh shit, I won't be smoking cigarettes. But I just thought, you know what, I didn't want to turn it down. First time experiencing shit. I was like, okay, cool. So J-Boy, he was never a smoker. He does it nowadays, but he was never, you feel me? I did not have no influence in that, you know what I'm saying? I'm be straight up. So now we going into blocks. J-Boy was like, you know what I'm saying, fist bumping. She's like, I'm going yard, bro, I'm going home. Like, okay, shit, alright. Went into the blocks now. Went into like, I think it was like the fifth floor. Started strapping up and shit. Main man was like, bro, take small talks, cuz. Bro, I'ma try these voices. Like, you know when you smoke this shit, take slow puffs, cuz. That's how he's spoken, bro. That's exactly how my guy spoke. I was like, shit, okay. So it was me, his hench friend, you know what I'm saying, the big guy, and me. Bro, okay, taking advice. He's like, this shit you gonna smoke? Cool purple haze. I'm like, what the hell is this guy talking about? I thought a cigarette and shit. I was like, okay, cool. He's like, this is gonna be the highest shit you ever smoked, cuz. I was like, alright, straight. You feel me? That's me just like getting ready for my first puff and shit. I was like, oh shit, it's gonna be wild. Bro, pass. Them two were passing it together as if it was like I was the defender and shit, and like, come say a sucker up in this bit. Main man gives it to me. He's like, take slow puffs, cuz. Cause this shit gonna make you fly. I was like, alright, we straight. Bro, I took one puff. I was like, okay. Blew it out. Took a second puff. Okay, you feel me? Took a third one. He's like, oh, take it easy, bro. Don't take too much pulls. This time I'm thinking, bro, you guys had so much pulls. You telling me to take it easy? He's like, yo, it's your first time. You don't want to be going crazy. I was like, alright, bet. Bro, gave it to him. I was thinking to myself, shit, I've never smoked this shit in my life. Purple haze, this shit is sweet. It had some flavor to it. I was like, god damn. I know this shit was this nice. But nothing hit me at this point. Come round again. He gave me another. I had another two pulls after. And I said, yo, I'm gone. You feel me? He's like, oh, you flying already? Bro, I said to him, bro, no, I'm straight, bro. I'm just waiting for this shit to kick in, bro. It just feels like it's a normal cigarette, cut. These times, I never smoked a cigarette, you feel me? He's like, all right, go home safe, you know what I'm saying? I was like, we're straight. Went home, knocked at Jay. No, I didn't even knock at J-Boy's yard. I went straight to yard. J-Boy texting me and phoning me. He's like, yo, bro, what's up? Like, homie, I don't feel no effect. I just took some two tokes on, or three tokes, or let's just say five or six. On this purple haze shit. She ain't kicking in yet. He started laughing on the phone. You know what I'm saying? I was like, oh gosh. Went into my yard now, bro. Bro, I started to feel hungry as shit, bro. Bro, my favorite snacks, bro, were biscuits and crisp, but mostly biscuits, bro. Any snack in the world, I don't care about chocolate or crisp, bro. Biscuits are my shit. You feel me? Now I was laying there, bruh. It felt good, but I didn't get the full effect. That was my preview. That wasn't my official shit. Oh, by the way, before I do start this next one, this official shit, it's gonna make sense if I add it to the end of the story, but I'd just rather tell you now in the middle and just carry on with the official, what we was here for, you feel me? Coming after what I was meant to say, I left the hood and shit, y'all know that. I went college, left college, done what I got to do, you know what I'm saying? Had a court case, that shit made me change my mind about life, bro. I hit my head on the wall. Judge was like to me in my case, bro, I don't want to see you here again. I was slapping the wrist, you feel me? I was like, all right, cool. I'm out, bro. You ain't going to see me here again, bro. Listen, a month after that, I was so depressed, but I was hell, like, smoking that shit crazy. Left the country, came to the island. As y'all know, I became a soccer player, you feel me? I ain't going to tell you what team. I was playing for a soccer team in London. I ain't going to tell you that shit as well, because that shit private. Hopefully one day, if I do get paid on the YouTube, baby, I'll probably tell you. You feel me? So now I'm a wise guy. I've learned from my mistakes and my experience. I've never broken the law, never done anything stupid to not, never harmed anyone, you feel me? I'm a good hearted dude. After like 16, I'm going through that hard time, court case. I changed, bro. I'm not the type of homie that I was. Probably still a bit bipolar in my head. That's the only thing I need to work on. But hey, I'm straight. You already know that. So, skipping a year now, I was 16. I'd left school, going into college now. I was already actually in college. I was like 16 going on 17. So these times, my girl was like picking up the phone, was like, hey, Jay. My girl used to live in West London, you feel me? Kind of like outskirts of London. You know what I'm saying? It's still a trick, bruh. He was telling me, yo, Jay, on the weekend, I'm trying to go out with my girls. She's like, I've forgotten her name. I don't know if it was Chloe or Sophie, but let's just call her Chloe for the sakes of it. She like, hey, Jay, do you want to come to the outskirts of London, basically outside of London, and chill with me? We're going to hang out with my friends and shit. I was like, shit, what's up? I was trying to clap cheeks, you know what I'm saying, bruh? I was like, that time, so I ain't going to pay for no hotel or anything like that. All right, bet. Come to the weekend now. I took the bus all the way to freaking West. That shit took like 3-4 hours, bro. That's hell of a journey, bro. I'll tell you that shit, bro. God damn. Bro, man, it was missions, bro. But listen, I don't care about y'all telling me about long distance relationships and shit. I don't care, man. That shit was still good for me. That shit worked out. Met up my ex now in West. She took me all the way to outside of London or the outskirts, bro. Chilling there, came to the evening. I was like, so what you girls gonna be doing there? My friend's coming over, you know what I'm saying? We gonna stay at Chloe's. Let's just put it as Chloe, you feel me? My girl Caribbean, you know what I'm saying? Y'all already know how much I love my Caribbean girls, man. Oh shit. Bro. So now we staying at her yard. She had a free freaking yard. I was like, cool, someone gonna get jiggy tonight, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, bruh. So it was like 7 p.m. and shit. No, it's kind of like, it was in the summer, so it was still sunny, still bright outside. They're taking out bottles, bruh. I'm a dude, I used to drink, after this story that I'm telling you, now the official time that I've literally puffed, bro, I had a period when I broke up with my ex, so I was drinking tough. But I ain't a drinker, bro. You know what I'm saying? I do smoke roll-ups now and then. Smoking, I probably do that as a medication if I'm ill, going through a really hard time. But I don't touch it, nevertheless. You feel me? That's the purpose of it. You know what I'm saying? I don't smoke it like it's a normal, happy day every day, just talking like a chimney. You know what I'm saying? No, sir. But yo, check me out, though. So we hit up the yard. I met her friend, Chloe, for the first time. English girl, proper English girl. You know what I'm saying? With the posh accent and shit. Oh, shit. Bro, I was wild. Dope girl, though. So, yeah, she had a dog. Some big-ass dog, bro. I'm telling you, this shit was big-ass, you know what I'm saying? Big-ass mofo. Check me out. So now, a next friend come over, bro. Some Colombian thing, you know what I'm saying? Bro, I was there like, Ross, your friend for her age. She hella produced. She looked like a woman that was 25 or 27, bro. And she was tall, bruh. She could have reached for the sky and touched those clouds, bruh. She didn't have to go on her tippy toe, bruh. That girl was sexy, bruh. But me, I had to be low. I had to keep it straight. You feel me? Even though I did want to clap those cheeks and go wild, bro, I had to stay loyal for my girl, bruh. No cap. Temptation was real tough. But hey, man, I'm a loyal dude. You know what I'm saying? Late night now. They were about to get ready to go to the club and shit. So it was like three girls. I'm one dude, you know what I'm saying? I thought, what what a lucky guy I'm going to be later on. You know what I'm saying? I didn't know we were going to be off of was only drinks and going wild. You feel me? Now, she talking about taking out the weed and shit, rolling up some big... This Colombian gal knew how to roll up to rotten, bro. She was the only one that knew this shit like tough. Like, damn, girl. Okay. Bro, we went down outside. Bro, and their bus stops are weird, blood. Their bus stops are like huts, bro. In bricks, bro. You know, like, that story? That childhood story of, what is it called? Big Bad Wolf and blowing the, you know, house down with straw. You know what I'm saying? And all that shit, bro. This was made out of, like, bricks, bro. I've never seen a bus stop made out of bricks, bro. The ones in London be like plastic and glass. You feel me? Bro, it was wild, but it's nice to see some countryside type shit for the first time. That was the only time I actually left the hood or left inside London to do that shit or go do anything else. I'll hopefully one day see more if I do go out to those type of sides, man. It'd be a nice experience. But hey, went outside, bro. Next two homies came. Apparently, it was Chloe's friend. I'm thinking, bro, someone told me about other guys coming up. But I was like, okay, I'm keeping my cool. Bro, they were having fun, bro. Me, I'm a type of person where I'm kind of antisocial. I don't like to mix up with too many people, you feel me? So I was just talking to my girl, which is my ex. And these two other guys, I think they were like from the Caribbean, or one was African. Chilling, we all puffing and shit. Bro, they passing me the shit and I'm smoking like it's a cigarette, bro. My ex looks at me like, Jay, you about to smoke that whole shit? I was like, oh shit, I didn't mean to be greedy, you feel me? I passed it on. Came back again to me puffing, bro. I was nodding my head. At this point, bruh, I'm nodding my head. I know this shit, bruh. Randomly nodding my head, bruh. I could hear music in my head for some weird random reason, cuz. Nodding my head, bruh. My ex looking at me and, like, nudging me like, hey, Jay, why are you nodding your head? You can hear some music. She's just laughing. I'm like, bruh, I can hear the beat in my head. And I for real feel like I was about to freestyle some tough bars, bruh. You know what I'm saying? Blood. Check me out, though. These guys already had drinks. Me, I was just on the puff. You know what I'm saying? Bro, I stood up. I was the only one that stood up. These guys were still... You feel me? I stood up, bro. I thought I could hear sirens. Like, goddamn, bro, where them sirens coming from? I don't know, bro. Even today, I don't even know if it was literally sirens, bro. I got up from the freaking bus stop, bro. I walked around the other side of the bricks. You feel me? Like it was covered. So if the popo came, I was about to dash. You know what I'm saying, bro? I didn't want to get caught with those, you know what I'm saying, around. You know what I'm saying? I was ready to run, bro. All I can hear is, Jay, bro. I felt like, no cap, yo. I felt like, if y'all have played, I know there's many of y'all that have played it before. GTA San Andreas, bro. I felt like I was on a mission hiding from those five stars from the police, bro. The popo. No cap, bro. I was proper, like, hiding, like, my ex come out of nowhere behind me. He's like, Jay, what you doing? I was like, can you hear those sirens? Bro, I was bugging out, good. That was some high shit, bro. I was bugged out. Next thing now, she's like, hey, there's no sirens. That day was like, let's just go in anyway. Bro, I swear there were sirens. They wouldn't have said, oh, let's go in anyway. Maybe they were just thinking about me. Hey, love him. You know what I'm saying? If he was. I ain't even know. They went into the yard now. They started drinking. They were getting ready to go to the club, all of them. I don't do clubs. I've never done, only once. I only done it because it was my ex's birthday and I done it just for her, you feel me? But I ain't a club type person. So we went into the yard now. I had to look after Chloe's big ass dog. And I didn't even know if Chloe liked me, you know what I'm saying? Bro, this dog got it so freaking comfortable, bro. And one thing with me, while smoking, bro, I was getting horny as hell, blood. This thing was steaming. I was like, bro, what the hell's going on here? Is this Viagra or some shit? Bro, I was chilling at yard, waiting for them to come from the club. So they all left. I'm just there chilling on the couch, watching TV. I was like, bro, this TV's dead, bro. I'm just there looking at the time, just staring at the time. Like, hurry the frick up. Dog's all getting comfortable and shit. I was like, shit, this dog gonna bite off my freaking arm or some shit. Bro, there was one point, this dog actually got into the couch, sat there, made slow moves onto my freaking lap, bro. I was like, what the hell? I didn't even want to say anything to the dog. I don't know what a dog gonna do to me, baby. Hell no, bruh. Bro, so anyway, after like an hour of that dog just sitting his face onto my lap, they came in, blood. Chloe. Yeah, all happy and shit. Guys came in with them. I was like, you okay, cool, bruh. Y'all still here, you know what I'm saying? I don't like too many guys around me, bro. Yeah, so we was chilling. Bro, we smoked another one in the living room before we went to bed. So we each had a room, bro. Chloe, I think parents was rich or some shit. I don't even know, bro. Chloe had a room. One of her guys went and stayed in her room. Like, damn, okay. Vicky just went into her room next. I was like, shit, that's your guy. I didn't know that shit. But low-key, before we even went into the freaking yard, each room, I saw one hombre, one guy, just chilling there, checking out my girl, bruh. I was going crazy. Oh no, I'm slightly bipolar. So I went out, bruh. I steamed out of there, bruh. I was thinking, bro, you meant to be my girl. You two keep making eye connection and shit. What the hell is going on here, bruh? God damn, bruh, I dashed out. I was like, bruh, I'm ready to go sleep or go home, bruh. At that time, I couldn't go home because no bus was running at that time. 11, was it? 12? 1 a.m.? Bro! No buses, bro. I was like, I can't go home. That's pissed, bro. Anyway, my ex came in, closed the room, the door from the living room. I was like, Jay, what's up? Like, bro, I see that guy checking you out and shit. Y'all just done went to the club and y'all just here. Bro, at this point, that smoke, again, that we had, ain't even get me a horny as shit. I wanted to clap in cheeks, baby. I can't even clap your friend, cause I'm trying to be loyal to you. You know what I'm saying? Bro. She went on a mad tip, blood. Like, she didn't even just say it calmly, like, Jay, look, just calm down, you're bugging out. You feel me? Nothing going on. She went on a mad tip. She was going crazy. I was thinking, bro. So that just makes me think some shit is going on, you know what I'm saying? So I thought, hey, man, I'm going to go chill. Oh, you tell me to chill. Bro, I was silent throughout the whole thing, even before when we were smoking outside, even inside, bro. Antisocial as hell, bro. Unless I know you, and I know you're cool, and I know you got, you know what I'm saying, you're not doing no stupid shit on road and shit like that, then we can be cool, as long as you don't keep bothering me every single day, you feel me? My girl was like, after 10 minutes chilling, was like, call it a night. We all went in each room. I was like, Jesus, I started to get horny and shit, you know what I'm saying? But we're about to kill our cheeks, bro. She laid down. And what did she say to me, bro? I feel sick. I can't do this shit. I was like, bro, the whole point, we came over to your freaking friend's house. What's the, you know what I'm saying? I was like, all right, cool, bet. I'll be straight.
That day, bro, my vision was blurry. My head was all over the place, bro. I didn't even know what was going on with me, bro. I was wild. Now you heard the story how it first time affected me thinking I was playing GTA and I was one of the characters going wild and hiding from Five Strikes Police and shit. And getting all horny, bro. That shit get me mad horny, bro. Took L's after that, but hey, year after that we split up. I moved to the island. You know what I'm saying? We split up and shit. But hey, life, you know what I'm saying? That's how it goes. It's not a thing that I say it was a bad experience. It's just an experience once in a lifetime, not to say. Some people do it and don't do it again. Some people do it and do it every freaking day till they go crazy some shit. Some people learn that it's just medication and only for good purposes, just to have fun or some shit. That's how my story went, man. If y'all ever want to hear any other story time, man, just hear spam up. Matter of fact, I was about to hear spam up that comment section what story y'all want to hear me tell y'all next, bro. Or hit me up on the IG or the Snap, you feel me? Your boy be going local up on this, but giving you some different type content. You know what I'm saying? Your island boy be out from here on. Hit that like button. Smash the subscribe button. You know how we do. I'm out.